the battle. You see my victory.
Welcome back to another Jay's Trucking Show with your host, Jay. I am going to Ashton, Kansas today. That is where I'm at as of right now. I am getting loaded. And we are going to Brewster, Ohio today. There's about 800 and something miles there. We are picking up flour today from Bungie. And it is going to a food store in Ohio. Pretty interesting. Whenever they get done unloading me here, guys, I'll go back there and I'll show you guys about what it looks like, what kind of packaging it is. He said it's got some cardboard box on the floor. So I'm guessing whatever it is, it's not on crates or any type of anything. You know, it's not sitting on anything. So anyway, guys, so this video is going to be about the load going to Ohio. If you guys like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Please let me know if you guys are liking these videos. If so, I will continue to do these type of videos. That right there is what we got right now. I got a red light. Red light going on back there. So they're loading us. As you can see, the truck's shaking. But, yeah, guys, so I'll let you guys know whenever they get it unloaded.
Got the load unloaded. Going inside to get the bill of ladings. And as soon as I get outside of here, guys, I'll let you guys see what the back of the load looks like, and I'll be right back. So I wasn't able to get no video footage. Guys sit there and talk to me. I didn't get a chance to pull my phone out, but I did get a picture of it. So I'll show you guys the picture of the whole thing.
All right, guys, we're out of here. We are on our way to Ohio. Guys, this weekend I've got some stuff that I'm going to be doing on the channel, and I got some stuff that I'm going to be adding to the truck here. I got a leveling valve that I'm going to put on. If anybody's wondering how to be able to put on a leveling valve on a Peterbilt 579, I will be more than happy to show you how to do it. Also, I got some stuff coming up on the channel. I've got some
a thing. I don't want to miss the melody.
singing over me. Heaven singing all around me. Your touch is a wound of sun. Your touch is a lingering kind. I'm a child reaching up for your hand in mine. Swing me round, I want to fly. Hey, I don't wanna miss it. I don't wanna miss a thing. So I kind of been a sycamore.
So, guys, on the right, we're in Indianapolis today. Today is Tuesday. Gotta be at the shipper or the pickup tomorrow. So, we are in Indianapolis, and I tell you what, man, it is bad today. It is bad. I have went through road construction. Interstate 65 South was shut off. Interstate 70 East was shut off.
Take exit 42.
Literally had to go all the way around
36 East.
Indianapolis in order to get through that. Through downtown to places that I never thought that this truck would even make it through. But other trucks was doing it, so I had to make the best of it and do it without not tearing up my equipment. That's the main thing I always think about, you know. All these company drivers, yeah, they can do that. It ain't their truck. They don't care. Well, guess what? I'm in the process of owning mine. So, why tear it up? Why tear it up? Do what you gotta do to keep it safe, guys. Don't tear your equipment up because it makes it seem like you got to. You don't have to do nothing. The only thing you gotta do is praise God, live, die, and pay taxes. That's all you got to do.
So,
you don't have to do that, guys. But anyway, today, we're going to talk a little bit about how drivers think that it's okay to just stay on the diesel island. Okay? I'm going to tell you this. Drivers can get mad, put in the comments, say whatever they want to say, but at the end of the day, guys, you get done finishing fueling, please pull forward and don't sit there for 30, 40 minutes. Come on, man. Us drivers, we got stuff we got to do too, and we don't have time to deal with that kind of stuff. So all I ask is you please, when you get done fueling, sit there for just a minute, do what you gotta do, get yourself situated, go inside, maybe get you a beverage or get you some food to go on the road. Don't sit there for 30 minutes. Come on, man. Pull over somewhere, get out, you know what I mean? You know, a lot of places you can pull over on the shoulder even though it says no parking. I know a lot of drivers that pull on the side of the road and it says no parking, and I mean the whole road's full. So, tell you what, I've also felt victim to get a ticket as well. So you got to be careful, guys, about pulling on the side of the road. But anyway, yeah, that was kind of the topic today. We're still on the Brewster, Ohio delivery, and we'll be there tonight in about 314 miles when we got to go. Be there, so I'll keep you guys tuned in. It's raining right now. I can't get great footage, so I'll see you guys in a few minutes.
Hey guys,
so as you guys know, it's DOT week this week. The cops are pretty bad. They are not looking like they're gonna be friendly this week. I've been seeing a whole lot of them. Matter of fact, I'm coming up on one as we speak. And they are after them today. That's for sure. They are not playing any games. That's for dang sure. So, if you guys are out driving around, I keep on looking back there. Like, oh, I don't want them to come after me. Nah, you stand back there. I'm not speeding or nothing. But, you know, it's DOT week this week. They're really looking for people that's speeding. So if you guys are speeding, man, slow the rig down, man. You don't have to be running. I don't care what these companies say. They thinking they gotta keep you in a big old hurry and this and that. Let me tell you something. That's how wrecks happen. You get in a big old hurry and stuff happens. You don't want to get no wreck because of the company saying, oh, you gotta be in Ohio in 18 hours, or you gotta be in Ohio in 3 hours. You're like, dude, I'm only in Illinois. That's impossible. Well, you know what that means. Without them telling you, that means, hey, you better speed. That's what they want to tell you, but they can't tell you that because they know that the company policy, typically that trucks are governed at 65 or this or that. Well, that's one good thing about custom critical carriers is all of our trucks are typically governed around 70. So we don't really have that problem. Which ain't that bad. I'm still back there. I don't want them coming after me. We are in Ohio. We just crossed the main line. And I figured I'd update you guys and let you guys know what's going on here. We are almost here to deliver the load. We picked it up Monday evening, I'm sorry. Today is Tuesday. We'll be there tomorrow morning. So we will be there tonight, obviously. We'll take a 10-hour break, and I'll see you guys after I take a 10-hour break. There may be some footage behind this. I may video one more time before I close the day out. But if I don't, I'll see you guys Wednesday morning. All right, guys. We're finally unloaded from the Brewster, Ohio load. That's going to be it for this video. I appreciate you guys watching. I hope you guys like, comment, and subscribe. And we'll see you guys on the next video. But for now, you guys have a wonderful day. Have a blessed day. All glory to God, always. And I'll be starting the next video for you guys. But for now, Jay's out. Take care. And just the thought of letting go. Well, it's brought you to your knees. Oh, but if you can make it, you can make it through the night. I can promise that the sun is gonna rise. You'll wake up just a little bit stronger. So hold on just a little bit longer. 'Cause it's only